Hey guys, I'm pretty sure I'm not the only one that had problems with the Wi-Fi of the Fritz aka AVM product. So I got myself a Ubiquiti Wi-Fi access point and I'm going to do a proper unboxing and I'm going to show you guys how to set it up. And I'm pretty sure it's one of the easiest Wi-Fi products right now on the market and the most reliable ones. So what do we have here? We have a little product guide. And then we already have the access point. To be honest, it's way smaller than I thought. It's pretty much as big as my hand and I have really little hands. So, and the design isn't bad either. So I guess this is definitely something you can hang on the wall or on your ceiling. Looks good. So you have a base mount included. Shouldn't be too hard to mount the thing. And a little how to get the stuff up and running. And what's really cool, and sometimes they don't mention it, it comes with a PoE injector included, so you don't need an extra one. If you also have the Ubiquiti switches, you don't even need a PoE injector because they have it already included. Some more screws, some more mounts, and I think that's pretty much it. Let's get to work. Guys, I was just fiddling around with the kind of like UFO shaped access point. And this thing here, this ring, is the wall mount. And before you break it, see that little hole? There you go in with a screwdriver and then you can lift this nose up. And then you can open it. And obviously, something is in there that I think shouldn't be making any noise, so hopefully it's not broke.
Okay, now you have seen what's in the box, but you don't know my setup right now. I'm going to show you how I've set up my Fritz equipment right now with the Fritz box, and I'm going to show you how it will look when the Ubiquiti is in. So let's get to it.
Here now you can see my whole network setup. So here in the middle we have a Fritz AVM 6490 cable router. From there I go right next to the 16 port Netgear switch. This 16 port switch is my main switch, so I'm going from this spot to every other peripheral I use. Right next to it, I also have a PowerLAN TP-Link adapter. I have an 8-port switch in the living room. I have another 5-port Netgear switch in the office. From the 5-port switch, I go into the Fritz repeater, so it's connected with 1 gigabit. From this setup, we are going to change it to this. So basically the only thing that will change is that I get rid of the Fritz AVM access point in the office and I'll turn off the Wi-Fi at the router. So the only Wi-Fi access point I'll have will be the new Ubiquiti one that is going to be set up here in this area of the apartment, right on top of the ceiling. Now I'm going to show you how to connect it physically and how to set up the basic software. So before you plug in the access point, you have two connectors. You have the main and the secondary.
The main is for PoE and the main connection only. The secondary is just for bridging, so watch out. After a while it starts blinking and now it has a white light around. So now you see that it's working.
The first thing you need to do is to install Unify Controller software, but to use it you need Java, so let's first get Java. If you want to use any cloud functions of the Ubiquiti equipment, choose the 64-bit version of Java. The installation and the initialization takes a few minutes, but then we can head over to the web-based setup. To start the configuration, you put in your server's IP address and then you add at the end the port 8443 and then you're good to go. First of all, you need to set up the country you live in and select your time zone. The Unify controller automatically scans your network for any supported devices and then lists them below so you can head over to the Wi-Fi configuration. But first we have to disable our existing Wi-Fi on the Fritz box. The SSID and the secure key you define here will be rolled out throughout the 2.4 GHz and the 5 GHz Wi-Fi network. You also can enable a guest network, but you cannot specify any credentials for it, so you'll need to do that later. On the controller access, you define the admin's login name and password, so be pretty sure about what you add in here, because you definitely will need to remember it. At the beginning, I did not activate the cloud access feature because I did not need it, but you can activate it later on if you install the 64-bit version of Java, and with that you're able to access your configurations throughout the mobile app wherever you are. At the end you get a quick configuration overview. And then you're already on the main login screen. Depending on what devices you installed, you'll get different information in the overview area. Unfortunately, for most of the features, you need a Unify Secure Gateway. In the statics area, you can browse your active clients and their data consumption. For a better overview, you can upload floor plans and place your active devices on them. In the devices area, you see all your active devices and you also can launch any firmware upgrades from here. In the settings area, you're able to configure your whole site, not just one device. And a really cool thing is that it displays you all the available features even if you don't have the right hardware for it, for example with the Unified Secure Gateway. For band steering, you need to activate the advanced features. In the wireless networks area, you can define all your active Wi-Fi's on the access point and you're able to set the active password and the encryption method. It is also a really cool feature that you can define the supported connection speeds to every band. And last but not least, don't forget to head over to the networks area and specify your designated gateway IP address. And to make sure that your access point operates on the best radio frequency, head over to devices, go to RF environment and start the scan, but be aware, the scan can take more than 5 minutes and all your devices will be dropped from the access point. Now I'm going to show you guys how to force different frequencies to different Wi-Fi's. So you go to your devices browser, you select your device and you go to configuration. There you have the area called VLANs. And here you can see the 2.4 GHz area and the 5 GHz area and your designated Wi-Fi's. If you click on edit, you're able to disable this Wi-Fi for the 2.4 GHz area. So with this method, you can force different devices into different kind of Wi-Fi's. The other solution would be the band steering option. With the band steering option, you can choose whether you want your devices to prefer the 5 GHz or more like a balanced configuration. It automatically shifts between 2.4 GHz utilization and 5 GHz utilization. So it's up to you what you prefer and how you want to set up your environment. Now I will give you a quick peek how fast our internet is throughout the Wi-Fi. For this I'm heading over to speedtest.net. As you clearly can see, it has no problem to maintain the overall upload and download speed. So to give you a better impression, let's head over to before and after we install the Ubiquiti equipment. For this I used an app called NetSpot Pro. Basically, you load a floor plan into it, you define your measurements and you start walking around your apartment, and where you stand you click on the map and the app starts to measure the quality of the connection and measures the download and upload speed. Afterwards, you receive a heat map concerning your connection quality, and as you can see clearly in the Fritz picture, we have a lot of blue areas. Those areas are not covered really good. And if you compare it to the Ubiquiti, we have the access point located in the middle of the apartment, but still we have a lot of warm spots. If you compare it to the Fritz version, even around the access points of the Fritz equipment, the red areas are really, really small.
All right, guys, so here's some feedback after I've been using the Ubiquiti access point for 1 week now. So there are certain things I definitely noticed in comparison to the whole Fritz equipment. For starters, if you use a lot of Apple products, you will definitely notice a way quicker connection with the Wi-Fi. So especially if you use an Apple Watch to unlock your MacBook or something, the connection is way faster and way more reliable. So overall, I have to say I'm very pleased with the Ubiquiti access point. I'm really surprised how fast it is to set up. It's really reliable, and I now can cover our whole apartment with just one access point to cover a 90 square meter apartment. The options you get with it are definitely worth it, and if you're kind of like a geek and you're into features and like monitoring and stuff, you will have a lot of fun with it. So thanks again for watching. I hope it was a little bit helpful for you guys. If you liked today's episode, please give me a big thumbs up. And if you wanna stay tuned for more techie and nerdy stuff, please subscribe down below. I hope to see you next time.